A and B can do a piece of work in 20 and 15 days respectively. They worked together for 6 days, after which B was replaced by C. If the work was finished in the next 4 days, C alone can do it in how many days? A and B can do a piece of work in 20 and 15 days respectively. A plus B's 1 day work is equal to 1 by 20 plus 1 by 50. This comes to 7 by 60. They worked together for 6 days. In 6 days, 7 by 10th work is completed. That means 3 by 10th work is left out. A and B can do a piece of work in 20 and 15 days respectively. So one day they can do together 7 by 60th of the work. They work for 6 days. 6 days 7 by 10th work is completed. That means 3 by 10th work is left out. This is completed in the next 4 days. This is completed in the next 4 days. So 1 into 4 into 10 by 3. That is 40 by 3 days. In this problem, we have to find out C alone can do it. In this problem, we have to find out C alone can do it. So C's 1 day work is equal to combined work of A plus C minus individual work of A. C's 1 day work is equal to combined work of A plus C minus individual work of A. A plus C's 1 day work is equal to 3 by 40. A's 1 day work is equal to 1 by 20. Question number 23. A, B and C can do a work in 36, 54 and 72 days respectively. They started together, but A left 8 days before and B left 12 days before the completion. C worked for how many days? Total number of days we will take it as X. X can do a piece of work in 36 days. In 1 day he can do x into 1 by 36, that is x by 36. A can do a piece of work in 36 days. X into 1 by 36, x by 36. He left 8 days before. B's capacity is 54 days, but he left 12 days before. X capacity is 72 days. So answer is 24 days. So answer is 24 days. That is multiple choice A. Question number 24. A can do a piece of work in 15 days of 8 hours each. And B finished it in 6 2 by 3 days of 9 hours each. If they work 10 hours for each day, they can do together in. A can do a piece of work in 15 days of 8 hours each. A can do a piece of work in 15 days of 8 hours each. 1 day 8 hours, so for 15 days 120 hours. B, 6 2 by 3 days of 9 hours each. B, 6 2 by 3 days. 6 2 by 3 improper fraction is 20 by 3. So this will become 60 hours. So they can do it together in apply the shortcut method. Product of the denominators by sum of the denominators. Product of the denominators by sum of the denominators. 40 hours. But they are working 10 hours per day. Total number of hours taken to complete the work is 40 days. But they are taking 10 hours per day. At the rate of 10 hours per day, totally it will take 4 days. Totally 40 hours are required. They are working 10 hours per day. At the rate of 10 hours per day, it will take 4 days. So answer is 4 days. That is multiple choice B. Question number 25. A and B can do a piece of work in 4 days and 6 days respectively. If they work on alternate days, with B starting, the work will be finished in how many days? A and B can do a piece of work in 4 days and 6 days respectively. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 6. Alternate days, that means 2 days. In 2 days, 5 by 12th work is completed. Alternate days, that is 2 days. So 2 days, 5 by 12th work is completed. Whenever the question of alternate day concept comes in the examination, you must see how many times 5 cancels in 12, leaving apart the remainder. Whenever the question of alternate day concept comes in the examination, you must see how many times 5 cancels in 12, leaving apart the remainder. 5 cancels 2 times in 12. So 2 alternate days, that is 4 days. So 2 days, 5 by 12th work is completed. 4 days, how much work will be completed? So 5 by 6th work is completed. It implies 1 by 6th work is left out. 5 by 6th work is completed. It implies 1 by 6th work is left out. In this problem, who is starting? In this problem, B is starting. B's capacity is 1 by 6. Work left out is 1 by 6. So he will take 1 full day. So total number of days will be 1 plus 4. Total number of days will be 1 plus 4. So total number of days will be 1 plus 4, 5. So final answer is 5 days. That is multiple choice B. X and Y can do a piece of work in 10 days and 12 days respectively. If they work alternate days starting with X, the work will be finished in. X and Y can do a piece of work in 10 days and 12 days respectively. So 1 by 10 plus 1 by 12. 11 by 60. Alternate days, that means 2 days. In 2 days, 11 by 60th work is completed. Whenever the concept of alternate day comes in the examination, you must see how many times 11 cancels in 60, leaving the remainder. You must see how many times 11 cancels in 60, leaving the remainder. 11 cancels 5 times. 5 alternate. So 10. In 2 days, 11 by 60th work is completed. 10 days, how much work is completed? 11 by 12th work is complete. That means 1 by 12th work is left out. That means 1 by 12th work is left out. In this question, who is starting? X is starting. So what is capacity of X? 1 by 10. So 1/10th work he will do it in one day. 1/12th work he will do it in how many days? In this question, x is starting. X capacity is 1/10. 1/10th work one day. So 1/12th work how many days? 1/12 into 1 into 10/1. 5/6. So total number of days will be 5/6 plus 10. 10 5/6. Total number of days will be 5/6 plus 10. 10 5/6. So answer is 10 5/6. That is multiple choice B. A and B can do a piece of work in 8 days and 12 days respectively. If they work on alternate days with A beginning, the whole work will be finished in how many days? A and B can do a piece of work in 8 days and 12 days respectively. That is 5/24. In 2 days, 5/24th work is completed. Whenever the question of alternate day concept comes in the examination, you must see how many times 5 cancels in 24, leaving apart the remainder. 5 will cancel 4 times. So 8. So 8/2 into 5/24. 5/6. 5/6th work is completed. That means 1/6th work is left out. 5/6th work is complete. That means 1/6th work is left out. In this problem, who is starting? A is starting. A's capacity is 1/8. So work left out is 1/6. Capacity is 1/8. Work left out is 1/6. Capacity is 1/8. So capacity is less than the work left out. Capacity is less than the work left out. That means if you work for the whole day, still he cannot complete. Still this much work will be pending. Still 1/24th work will be pending. Capacity is 1/6, work left out is 1/8. So work left out is more than the capacity. So even if he works for the whole day, he cannot do. So still 1/24th work is left out. Since A is not able to do, he will take the help of B. B's capacity is 1/12. So 1/12. So 1/12th work he will do it in one day. 1/24th work he will do it in how many days? This will become half day. 1/12th work, one day. 1/24th work, how many days? Half days. So total number of days will be half plus whole day he has worked, half plus 1 plus 8. So total number of days will be half plus 1 plus 8. That is 9.5 days. So answer is 9.5. That is multiple choice B. Machines A and B produce 8,000 pins in 4 hours and 6 hours respectively. If they work on alternate hours starting with A, 8,000 pins will be produced in how many hours? It is also same like this only, same pattern. So answer is 4 2/3. That is multiple choice C. A is twice as good a workman as B. If they finish a work in 14 days, B can do it in how many days? A is twice a good workman as B. So we will assume. Question number 29. A takes X days. B will take 2x days. A is twice as good a workman as B. So if A takes 2 days, B will take x days. Together. So product of the denominators by sum of the denominators. Product of the denominators by sum of the denominators. This will comes to 2x by 3. This will come down to 2x by 3. This is given as 14 days. This is given as 14 days. Therefore, x is equal to 3 into 14 by 2. That is 21 days. That is 21 days. We have to find out b. B is taking 2x. X value is 21. 21 into 2, 42. So answer is 42 days. That is multiple choice D.